Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be solving one very interesting problem based on calculation of directivity of antenna. I have selected this problem from C.A. Balani's book. In my last video, I have explained directivity of antenna and I have derived equation of directivity, that is 4 pi u divided by p rad, where u is radiation intensity of antenna and P rad, that is radiated power of antenna. And based on that, I have explained you calculation of maximum directivity, that is 4 pi U max divided by radiated power. In this video, I'll be solving another question in which we are dealt with to identify maximum directivity of antenna, as well as we are dealt with to express directivity as a function of theta and phi. Here in question, we have been given with power density of dipole antenna. So power density, that is given as per a naught sine square theta divided by r square in the direction of ar. So from power density, we are dealt with to identify directivity. See, based on power density, one cannot calculate directivity directly. First of all, you will have to identify radiation intensity based on average power density. See, in my earlier videos, I have explained you calculation of radiation intensity based on power density, that is R square into W average, that is radiation intensity. So if you substitute W average, then this R square, that is getting cancelled, and radiation intensity will be a naught into sine square theta, right? Now based on radiation intensity, one can calculate directivity. Here first of all, we will be identifying maximum directivity. See, if you want to calculate maximum directivity, then maximum directivity that one can calculate as per 4 pi u max divided by radiated power, right? Based on this equation, one can calculate maximum directivity. Here we have radiation intensity, that is a naught sine square theta. So as if you want to express directivity as a function of theta and phi, then that one can express based on radiation intensity. See, this is maximum directivity calculation. And if you want to express directivity as a function of theta and phi, then directivity will be maximum directivity into, see, this function only. The reason is, here maximum intensity of radiation is a naught, so here maximum directivity will be d max, and into sine square theta, that you need to do, right? So here question is based on how to identify maximum directivity of given radiation intensity, right? Now here, if you observe this function, so with this function, maximum radiation intensity, that is a naught, right? So in this equation, u max is how much? A naught. Let me note down all the data. Here we have u max, that is a naught only, right? So now we need to identify radiated power. Based on that, we can have maximum directivity, right? So let us solve radiated power step by step. See, radiated power equation based on radiation intensity, that one should know. Radiated power, that is P rad, that is solid angle integration of radiation intensity. So if you do solid angle integration of radiation intensity, then you can have radiated power, right? Now solid angle integration, that is having two components, theta and phi. Let me explain you how it is there. Here, two components are there. One is theta, that is varying from 0 to pi. And second component is phi, that is varying from 0 to 2 pi. Sometimes students used to ask me like, why should we consider theta varying from 0 to pi and phi varying from 0 to 2 pi? See, here, if you consider antenna like this, then here, see, theta, that is vertical angle, that is varying from 0 to pi like this, right? And phi, that is horizontal angle, So that will be varying from 0 to 2 pi. It will be having complete circle, right? So here, see theta, that is varying from 0 to pi, and phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi. And u, that is a naught sine square theta, u is a naught sine square theta. And see this solid angle, that one should know, solid angle is sine theta d phi. Now we need to simplify this integration, and based on that we can have radiated power, right? So here, see this a naught, that is constant, take it outside. And here, see inside we will be having sine cube theta, right? So phi is independent function on this sine cube theta. So you can take separate integration of phi, that is varying from 0 to 2 pi, right? And you can do separate integration of theta over here, that is varying from 0 to pi sine cube theta, as it is independent function, right? Theta and phi both are independent on each other over here in terms of function. So separate integration can be done. So here, see this is a naught, and this integration, that is phi only, which is varying from 0 to 2 pi. And here we have theta, that is varying from 0 to pi sine cube theta d theta, right? So this limit, that is resulting into 2 pi only, but we need to identify this integration. So here I'll explain you how to identify this integration. So here what I'll be doing is I'll be taking this integration separately. The reason is I don't need to write this again and again, right? So I'm doing this integration separately. You see how here what I'll be doing is I'll be taking sine square theta into sine theta, right? So sine square theta, that is 1 minus cos square theta into sine theta d theta, right? So you see here sine cube theta, that is sine square theta into sine theta, where sine square theta is 1 minus cos square theta. Now with this, we can consider cos theta is equals to t, right? So here if I consider cos theta, that is equals to t, in that case, you can say differentiation of this, that is minus sine theta d theta, that is equals to dt. So this sine theta d theta, that is equals to minus dt, that we can substitute. And here we need to change limits even. Here theta belongs to 0 to pi over here, right? So what will be limit of t? If you substitute theta is equals to 0 in this, then t will be cos 0, means it will be 1. And if you substitute theta is equals to pi over here, then t will be cos pi, that is minus 1, right? Now we can place this in this to have a calculation, right? So this integration, now that is having limit with respect to t, where t is varying from 1 to minus 1. So t is varying from 1 to minus 1. And 1 minus cos square theta, now that is 1 minus t square. And sine theta d theta, that is minus dt, right? That is minus dt. Now we can further simplify this. So this is limit varies from 1 to minus 1. And if you multiply minus 1 inside, then t square minus 1 dt. Now we can simply integrate this. So t square integration is t cube by 3. And minus 1 integration is t, where limit is there from minus 1 to plus 1. Now if you substitute limit, then you see, if you substitute minus 1, then minus 1 cube by 3, that is minus 1 by 3. And if you substitute t is equals to minus 1, then here plus 1 will be there. And minus, now we need to substitute 1 inside this. So 1 by 3 minus 1. Now if you observe this, see 1 minus minus 1 means 2, right? And minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 means 2 minus 2 by 3 means that will be 4 by 3, right? So now we have this integration. Now we have this integration that is 4 by 3, right? So what we can do? We can have now radiated power, that is A naught 2 pi into 4 by 3, right? So now we have radiated power, that is 8 pi into A naught divided by 3. So now we got the value of radiated power, and we are having U max, that is A naught. So we can substitute U max, that is equals to A naught, and P radiated that we have calculated over here, right? And we will be having maximum directivity, where here U max, that is A naught, right? U max, this is A naught, right? That I have told you. If you substitute that, and if you substitute this P radiated, that is 8 pi A naught divided by 3, then this A naught, this 4 pi, this 2 will be getting cancelled, this 3 will go in numerator. So 3 by 2, that is maximum directivity over here, right? 3 by 2, that will be maximum directivity. And I have told you, if you want to represent directivity, if you want to represent directivity as a function, then that will be d is equals to d max into sine square theta. Initially I have explained that, right? So function over here with directivity will be d max into sine square theta. So you can say d max is 3 by 2, right? So d is 3 by 2 sine square theta. That is how we can have directivity calculation with respect to angle even, right? That is how we can solve problems. So you should be clear about what is directivity in form of radiation intensity. Even radiation intensity also I have explained in my earlier videos. Radiation intensity that I have explained. See, radiation intensity is having direct relation with radiated power, as well as radiation intensity that is also having relation with average power density, right? So radiation intensity is average power density into R square, that I have explained you earlier, and based on that we can calculate radiation intensity, and from radiation intensity we can calculate directivity, right? So all the fundamentals should be clear to have a solution of problems like this. Still, if anything that I would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.